Good afternoon, children. So in the previous class, so we discussed about autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition with the examples that present in our textbook. So in this class, I'm going to explain about the photosynthesis. So already we know that the photosynthesis means, photo means light, and synthesis means formation of different substances. Okay, in the presence of light, the plants are able to form the different kinds of substances. That's why the process is called as photosynthesis. Okay, actually the photosynthesis is in a process, so which plants containing green color pigments, so which are called as chlorophyll. So in the previous class we discussed about the chloroplast is an important cell organelle to perform the photosynthesis process in plants. Okay, so these green color pigments, chlorophylls, so that build the complex organic molecules from the simple inorganic molecules. So using light as an energy source. Okay, so here in the process of photosynthesis, so the plants are produces complex organic molecules. So what are the complex organic molecules? So first they form glucose. So which is in a complex organic molecule. So later this glucose is converted as in a starch, cellulose, according to the plant need. Okay, so what are the simple inorganic molecules are involved in the photosynthesis? That is mainly water and carbon dioxide. So these water and carbon dioxide, so in the presence of chlorophyll, so it build the complex organic molecules like sugars. Okay, so this is called as photosynthesis. Okay, so actually the photosynthesis is a very complex process. Okay, so actually the water and carbon dioxide, which is in a very simple molecules, simple inorganic substances, so when they combine, so in the presence of light, in the presence of chlorophyll, so it will form in a complex organic molecule, that is glucose. So actually in the single reaction, so it will be N. So actually it is not in a single reaction. So because of the photosynthesis is in a very complex process. So the first of all, the plants grabs the light energy. That light energy is converted into the chemical energy. And this chemical energy is utilized for the conversion of carbohydrates into, so conversion of carbon dioxide into the carbohydrate. Okay. So that's why there are many several intermediate compounds are formed during this process. Okay, so that's why it is in a very complex process that's shown by the plant. Okay, so here the about C.B. Van Neel, scientist in the year of 1931. So he was proposed a reaction or equation. So regarding to the photosynthesis, okay, that is in a widely accepted reaction. Okay, so in this reaction, so he is given an opinion. So that opinion was the for each molecules of carbohydrate formed. So for every one molecule of carbohydrate formed, so the process of photosynthesis that also produced one molecule of water and one molecule of oxygen. Okay, so he was given a statement. That statement is, for each molecule of carbohydrate formed, one molecule of water and one molecule of oxygen is produced. So which is in a C.B. Van Neel opinion regarding to the photosynthesis. Okay, so just to see that Van reaction equation, that is in a CO2 plus 2H2O. Okay, in the presence of light and chlorophyll. In the presence of light and chlorophyll, so they form carbohydrate plus water and oxygen. So one molecule of carbohydrate, along with that one molecule of carbohydrate, the process produced one molecule of water and one molecule of oxygen. So this reaction or this equation is proposed by Van Neel scientist. So can you balance this equation? So when we balance it, so it is 6CO2 plus 12H2O in the presence of light and chlorophyll, so it will form the simple sugar, that is glucose C6H12O6, and also produced 6 water molecules and 6 oxygen molecule. So it is in a balanced equation, so for the photosynthesis. Okay, now coming to the next slide. Okay, here the Van Neel first work on purple sulfur bacteria, so which is in a photosynthetic bacteria. not only the plants, some of the bacteria are also perform the process of photosynthesis. So actually he find that the light plays a specific role in photosynthesis. So without light there is no photosynthesis processes takes place by the plants and also bacteria. Okay, but so he used H2S instead of water, H2S instead of water as a starting material. So actually in the plants, carbon dioxide received by the plants and also water is received by the plants, but here the bacteria receive the carbon dioxide. Along with the carbon dioxide, the bacteria use the hydrogen sulfide instead of water, hydrogen sulfide instead of water as a starting material. So that's why here there is no oxygen produced by pulpal sulfur bacteria. Commonly the plants are take the carbon dioxide and also take the water. In the presence of chlorophyll and light, it will produce the carbohydrate. Along with the carbohydrate, so it produced water and oxygen, water and oxygen. But here Van Niel worked on pulpal sulfur bacteria, but he given H2S as a starting material. That's why the no oxygen is produced. Instead of oxygen, what is produced here? Sulfur is produced. Sulfur is produced. Okay. So later, the Robert Hill chose, okay, the O2 released from water, not from the carbon dioxide. Okay. So actually in the equation, what is present? CO2 plus H2O gives rise to C6H12O6 plus H2O plus O2. The O oxygen molecule that present in the carbon dioxide and as well as in the water. But whatever the evaluated or released oxygens which come from that carbon dioxide or water, so which come from that water only, which come from that water only, that is proved or showed by the Robert Hill scientist. That's why the reaction is called as Hill reaction. What it is called? Hill reaction. Okay, so the Robert Hill showed that O2 is released from the water. Again, I repeat it. Robert Hill showed that O2 is released from the water, not from the carbon dioxide. So because of the Van Niel conducted experiment on pulpal sulfur bacteria. So in the pulpal sulfur bacteria, this bacteria used the H2S as a starting material and they released the sulfur. So instead of oxygen, they released the sulfur. So that's why the oxygen, so which released from the water molecule only, not from the carbon dioxide, that confirmed by the Robert Hill scientist. Okay. So now, so the plants are synthesized simple carbohydrates, already I told you. So that is in a glucose. So later they formed the different complex ones as they need. So like starch, cellulose, and they are also forming the proteins and lipid molecules. Because of in the process of photosynthesis, first they form the simple carbohydrate. Simple carbohydrate, that nothing but it is called as in a glucose. So it is an example for the monosaccharide. Okay. So after this, monosaccharide may be formed as in a starch and cellulose, that are example for the polysaccharides. And the first they form the simple monosaccharides, later they form the more complex polysaccharides for their need and nothing but it is in a growth and development. So along with the carbohydrates, they also form the proteins and lipids. Okay. So here the animals are not able to synthesize carbohydrate, so they have to depend upon the plants for the same. So that's why the plants are also called as universal food providers. Already we discussed in the previous class. Okay. So this is a brief introductions regarding to the photosynthesis. So you remember one point here. So what is first one is an equation and second one is a Robert Hill reaction. So he showed that what it is, remind it, whatever the oxygen produced in the photosynthesis, so which is released from the water molecules, not from the carbon dioxide, Okay. So now coming to the next step. So the experiment is there. That is presence of starch in leaves. So it is in a very important 4 marks experiment. Okay. So whenever we conduct any kind of experiments in our laboratory, so we will follow a particular procedure. Already we discussed in the 9th class. So what is the procedure? The procedure is the first experiment that have in a different steps. So the first step is an aim. Okay. And second, materials required. Third, procedure. Fourth, observation. Fifth, result. And last one is What it is? Yeah, that is precautions taken by you. Okay, precaution taken by you. So these are the different methods that you follow when you conduct any kind of experiment in your laboratory. Okay, the experiment, what is the aim of this experiment here? The aim of the experiment is here, presence of starch in leaves. Presence of starch in leaves. So come to the next. What it is? Materials required. Materials required. Okay, what are the materials required here? So just you see the figure here. So the figure that contain beaker. So here the materials are beaker. And second one, boiling water. And third one, leaf. And fourth one, boiling tube. And next, asbestos gauge. And next, tripod stand, Bunsen burner, and petri dish. So these are the different materials. Once again, I repeat it. So the beaker, boiling water, leaf, boiling tube, asbestos gauge, tripod stand, Bunsen burner, and petri dish. So these are the materials. Along with these materials, so we need also two chemicals. We need also two chemicals. So that chemicals are, first one is methylated spirit, and second one is an iodine solution. Iodine solution. So sometimes they give one more questions like this. What are the chemicals used in the presence of starch in a leaf experiment? Okay, at the time you write methylated spirit and iodine solution. So these the two chemicals. Along with these two chemicals, so we also need some materials, that are beaker, boiling water, leaf, boiling tube, asbestos gauge, tripod stand, Bunsen burner, and petri dish. Okay, now coming to the procedure. So third step is a procedure. So first you take the beaker. First you take the beaker and take the water up to the 3/4. Okay, water up to the 3/4 only. Okay, so take in a beaker and fill it with the 3/4 with the water. Okay, so after that you take in a tripod stand and place a asbestos gauge on tripod stand. Asbestos gauge and tripod stand, and take in a Bunsen burner and lit on it. Okay, so you place the beaker on the asbestos gauge. So automatically what will be happen? The water is boil. The water is boil. Okay. So now you take a fresh young leaf, and that was placed in water first. That was placed in water first. So okay. So after few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes, so you take that leaf from the boiling water and placed into the tube. Okay. So in this tube, what you pour? You pour the methylated spirit. Okay, so now you place the tube into the boiling water. And you continually burn the Bunsen burner, and the water is heated, and automatically the methylated spirit is also heat. So whatever the color the leaf shows, which is green. Okay, so when you heat the water, automatically the leaf turns into the pale yellow color by losing its chlorophyll. Okay, because of the methylated spirit is in a solvent. So in that solvent, the chlorophylls are dissolved. So the chlorophyll pigments are dissolved in the methylated spirit. So that's why the green color leaf that turns into the pale yellow color. So when it is turns into the pale yellow color, so you take the leaf with the help of forceps. So without tearing, you take the leaf with the help of forceps and placed in a petri dish. So if the leaf contain any excess amount of the methylated spirit, so that was removed with the help of test paper, okay, or tissue paper, okay. So now you pour 1 or 2 drops of iodine, okay, 1 or 2 drops of iodine on the surface of the leaf. Okay, after adding iodine solution on the surface of the leaf, what will be formed? So the leaf turns into the blue or blackish color. Blue or blackish color. So the leaf turns into the blue or blackish color, that indicates, so it shows the presence of starting leaf. That shows the presence of starting leaf. So now take the precautions. What are the precautions? So don't fill the water full here, and also don't fill the methylated spirit full in the test tube, and don't heat the water excess near to the evaporation. Okay, don't heat the water up to the evaporation. Okay, so and take an young healthy leaf and take the leaf from the test tube without tearing, and add few or two or three drops of the iodine solution only, not excess amount. Okay, so these are the few precautions while conducting the presence of leaf experiment. Okay, now coming to the video, so regarding to the experiment, so just you watch it. Okay, actually the leaves, plants produce the glucose through photosynthesis, already we know it. So whatever the excess glucose that present in plants are converted as in a starch, so which is in a reserved food material. So now you see this experiment, it is in a petri dish, leaf, beaker, small beaker, iodine solution, boiling tube, Bunsen burner, tripod stand, and at best as gas. So first you lit in the Bunsen burner and place the beaker that containing 3/4 amount of water. So you have watched it, 3/4 amount of water. So first you place the leaf in a beaker. Okay, automatically the water is heated up, and now you take the leaf from the beaker and place it into the test tube with the help of forceps. So now what you take here? You take the methylated spirit. Okay, so completely the leaf is dipped in the methylated spirit, and this boiling test tube now placed into a beaker. So just you watch it carefully. Okay, the leaf completely dipped into the methylated spirit. Okay, so don't pour methylated spirit at the swap to the off. Okay, so the leaf completely dipped. Now you continue heat the water with the help of Bunsen burner. So automatically it is boiled, whatever the methylated spirit that have in a low melting point, that's why it is boiled. So just you see that methylated spirit is turns into the green color. So because of the leaves are lost its chlorophyll. So with the help of forceps, so you remove the leaf from the boiling tube and place it into a petri plate. So it is in a petri plate. Now you add in a 2 to 3 drops of iodine to the surface of the leaf with the help of dropper. So automatically actually the iodine that shows the brown color, after some time it shows the blue or blackish color. Now it shows the dark blackish, bluish blackish color. So that indicates the presence of starch. Okay, so which is an experiment regarding to the presence of starch in leaves. Okay, I hope you all understand. So if you have any doubts, so ping me in WhatsApp. Thank you.